Retro Rob's Gaming Videos.
Hey, Rob here, and I'm a little bit quiet today because my wife's trying to sleep still. It's kind of early in the morning, but yesterday I had a pretty good haul, and I wanted to show it to you. We hit the thrift shops yesterday. Hey, my wife wanted to. It wasn't me. So all this is totally her fault. I blame her. Actually, some of it she picked up herself, so I cannot be blamed for my actions. I suppose we should get started. First thing we picked up, this was actually kind of expensive. I think it was like 10 bucks, but it was Road Rash for the N64. I've been collecting N64 stuff quite a bit lately. And, I got something to show you real soon. I've got a orange Pikachu N64 that I've been fixing up, and that's just about ready. I'm going to show you how to mod it to run US games. It's a Japanese console. But anyway, yeah, I've been collecting quite a bit for N64, which this is, as I've mentioned before, like the first time I've owned an N64. I never bought it when it first came out. So it's really kind of cool that that I've got a new system to collect for, but also it's kind of like, oh man, do I really need more crap around the house? So I'm going to be doing a clean out too, a little bit of eBay. I know you totally watch this video to hear this kind of chatter, but anyway, I'm going to be selling a lot of stuff on eBay just to clear things out so I can clean up my collection a little bit and get just all the stuff that I really like on the shelf. Babble, babble, babble. Okay, so let's keep going. I got this. This is a Pinnacle. There we go. That's a USB recording device. As you know, I do a lot of gameplay video in my videos, and this particular one has an antenna in, which is a big deal because that means I can record older systems that don't have composite or component out. So that's really nice. Who knows if it works? I haven't tested it yet. So, but where's the tag? Dang it! It was $7 anyway. So, you know, it's worth a try if it works. It's going to be great because then I can record some older systems that I haven't been able to record. Got this lovely box for $2. It's one of those GameStop boxes. I've got a new Android device coming in that's going to fit in here. We'll be covering that in the next week or so. It should be coming in. But anyway, it came with a stylus. It's a DS. Oops, sorry. It's a DS box. It came with a stylus and a bunch of other stuff that goes with the DS. So I doubt it was used. Might have been, I don't know. Or at least it wasn't used much. So looks really clean, nice. I'll probably take that GameStop logo the hell off of there and put something else on there. I'm not a real big fan of GameStop. In case you didn't know, good Guys Games and Beer episode to watch is GameStop It, by the way. Check that out on the Guys Games and Beer channel. Talk all about my feelings on GameStop. Another thing I got was this Stamco handheld, and this is going to kill you. Number one, I used to have this, and I got rid of it and regretted it almost immediately. This is kind of the system that got me into collecting the Jack Specific type of stuff. Is this even really a Jack Specific? Let's see. Can't see on the bottom because of the tag, and I don't want to take off the tag. Yeah, it is. It is a Jack Specific. Okay, so this is a Jack Specific. It has Mappy on it, which I've covered in the past incorrectly. I'll cover it right this time. Galaga. I think it's got Bosconian on it, doesn't it? Yep. No? Yeah, no, Xevious it's got on this one. Miss Pac-Man and Pole Position. The cool thing about it is, with Pole Position, you turn left and right. And so this is a really good version of this. This is a very nice controller, and it was 99 cents. So that's really good. I haven't even hit the half price stuff yet, which is pretty crazy. Also picked up this is the Land Before Time Racing Adventure. I just pick up PlayStation stuff whenever I see it, just on principle. I've got a lot of PlayStation stuff. We'll have to go through my collection one of these days. It's pretty decent. I don't have every game, and I
don't know if I aspire to, but I've got a lot of them. I definitely won't ever collect like the sports titles because I don't want to fill my fill my shelves with football from every year. That's ridiculous. I think one is more than enough. Let's see. What else do we got here? We've got Battlefield 2. Sorry, for the Xbox. That was $2. If I know the price, I'll tell you. If I don't remember it, sorry about that. This was on the half price sale at St. Vincent de Paul, if you've ever checked this out. I don't know if they're everywhere, but in Wisconsin, they're pretty big. Gran Turismo 3. And this was half price, so it was really like $1.99. They do that. I think they jack up their prices before they have a half price sale. I'm not sure. It's one of those things where you get a text and it says, "Hey, you got half off." So if you have that text, you get half off. And this is another one of those for $1.99. Prince of Persia. I think that's a pretty good pickup for a couple of bucks. I don't know if I'd have paid $4 for them, but I sure will pay two. Off-road. I like the Test Drive series up until recently. It's pretty good. Oh, Crimson Skies. This one was also a half off, but not at Vincent DePaul. There was a lot of half off going on yesterday. Here we go. Love this game. This was like one of the first Xbox games that I totally got into. It's probably not. It'll probably hold up, I would imagine. But story-wise, it's just, I don't know. I just liked it. I like cheesy stories. What can I say? Medal of Honor: Rising Sun. I've started this game on several occasions. I may already have this game. Another one of those 199ers. This may not be the first copy. Let's see. This is crazy. This is a pink Nintendo DS in case. And it's a little floppily, but it's intact. It didn't have the power supply, so I haven't tested it yet. I can't believe I don't have a spare power supply for this thing laying around, so I'm gonna have to borrow one from a friend. But anyway, this was $6, so can't really complain. That was on a half off too. It was originally 12, so not bad. This one, unfortunately, I did pay the full $7 for. By the way, if you haven't seen my review of this, I now have two of these. This is great for stuff like MGC where, maybe I'll break one or something will happen to one. So anyway, I did do a review on this. You can check it out at my station. It's quite a good little machine. We had it out at MGC and a lot of people played it and they seemed to like it quite a bit. I was really impressed with how well people actually like this particular device. Very accessible and pretty good versions of games and a pretty good selection of games. I guess I can go through it real quick. I mean, I've covered this in depth, but anyway, there's Pac-Man, Galaga, Xevious. I'll show you the back. Dig Dug, Rally Axe, which is really good. I love that game. Super Pac-Man, Pac and Pal, Pac-Man Plus, Mappy, which I like, Galaxian, and Bosconian. This is the one with Bosconian in it. There we go. There's the back of that. Pretty cool. What else did I get? I've got a favorite thing in here. Oh! So, just like a week ago, I reviewed Volume 2 of the Radica Genesis, staring me right in the frickin' face at one of them, at one of the stores we went to, was this guy. It was $3. And so it's volume one of the Genesis. So needless to say, I'll be doing. Oh wait, it was $3.99. Sorry, there we go. Price on the side, and it was Goodwill. There we go. There's volume one, and I will definitely be covering this on a future video, since I already gave volume two the full review treatment. All right, let's keep going. How often do you get a $7 Xbox? There we go, $7 Xbox. Absolutely no cables whatsoever. Can't wait to test this and see if it works. But anyway, I figured, $7, it's worth a risk. Plus, you know, I mean, no power supply is not a big deal because it's a standard power supply. I have Xbox power supplies, Xbox video outs laying all over the place, so shouldn't be too hard to get this thing running. Actually, I got universals that'll work with it. Let's see. More. Got this for $3. This was a half pricer from $6. It's Ms. Pac-Man for the Genesis. Real mixed lot yesterday. A little bit of everything. This one I got actually a couple days ago. It was $20, but we had one of those coupons that took 25% off, so it was 15. And that's new. It's like wrapped still. For the Wii. Which is nice, because my Wii controllers just showed up. Ugh, I hate the name of that. The Wiimote. Sorry about the light. I don't know what's going on with that. It's backlighting, I think. Hosing us up. I'll try not to move my head. I also picked up this off of eBay. That's Rez. I got it for, I think it was $18 delivered. I won it for $15 and shipping was, I can do the math, $19 I got it delivered. There we go. Shipping was $4. So that's a pretty good deal. Love Rez. Great game. So it's going to be nice playing that. And then finally, all right, here goes the light again. It is my absolute, I don't know if it's my absolute, it probably is my favorite pickup of this week, is this. This is a Thrustmaster flight stick. It was $3. And it works perfectly. And it has, I'm going to do a full review of this thing too, because I'm pretty darn impressed with it. I've been using basically the same flight stick for years. I've been buying new ones of it as they break, but I'll cover that all in a separate video. But anyway, this thing is just, it's built like a brick. It has force feedback. It's really quite nice. By force feedback, I mean it's got a vibration function. It doesn't have true force feedback. Like a real force feedback joystick would, but still, it has like, you know, the modern equivalent of force feedback. So anyway, really cool, lots of buttons, really like that. And that is pretty much it. Thank you very much for watching this pickup video. If you enjoyed it, do me a favor, give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more. There will be reviews on a lot of this stuff upcoming. I love doing handheld reviews, so we'll be doing more. Also, I've got some indie game reviews. I've got a couple indie gamers who sent me in their games, and I'm going to be covering those as well in the upcoming week. Oh, another thing. Don't forget there is a link off to your, I think it's this way. That link is to my new tech station, and I have actually separated, because it's confusing. I know there's like people that come onto the station to watch some of my tech videos, and there's people that come on to watch my video game videos, and both of them get kind of like, why do I gotta watch the other? Well, you don't have to, but you know, a video comes on, you get flagged about it, and you're wondering why it's coming up. So anyway, I've actually separated those two, and I'm just starting to add videos to the tech station. So if you're a techie, go check that one out. Just started up. It's only got like one or two videos on it at this point, but I will be adding all new tech videos to that station. All right. Thank you very much for watching. Again, if you enjoyed this, do me a favor, thumbs up and subscribe for more. Bye.
Retro Rocks Gaming Videos.